Bismillah, alhamdulillah, wa salatu salam ala nabiyyina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa ashabi ajma'in. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Inna Allah yuhibbu al-tawwabin wa yuhibbu al-mutatahirin. Verily, indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves those that make tawbah, that they repent to Allah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves those who purify themselves. Purification of the heart through tawbah is from one of the best acts of ibadah that a person can do. And tawbah is ruju' ila Allah. It's going back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, returning to Allah and departing from the path of those who are astray or those who have earned the anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Tawbah has three requirements. The first is nadam, that the person has to have remorse. The second is al-iqla', that the person has to stop and immediately. And the third is they have to have the intention not to repeat the sin that they were doing. If it pertains to the rights of others, then there's a fourth requirement for tawbah to be valid and to be accepted. And it means returning the right that a person has taken from the other person. So let's take three sins. Sin of ghiba and namima, the sin of backbiting and slandering. If a person wants to rectify and make tawbah sincerely, then he has to, in the same gathering in which he was backbiting the person, he has to mention that person in good. Let's take the sin of stealing and theft. For the tawbah to be accepted, the person has to return the money. And if he's unable to return the money, then he has to give it in sadaqah and charity. Let's take the sin where a person's earning is mixed between halal and haram. They have to estimate how much of the income is haram and they have to give that away in sadaqah as well. This is if the sin and the ithm, it pertains to the rights of others. How does the worship of Allah see his sin, his transgression? He looks at the commands and the prohibitions of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and by doing so he acknowledges that he made the mistake and that he sinned. Or he looks at the promises and the threats, promises of reward and threats of punishment, and this leads him to repent to Allah, to have khawf of the punishment and to hope for the reward. And this leads a person to being a better worshipper of Allah, the true servitude of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to hope for Allah's reward and seek protection from Allah's punishment. So let us be those as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves, says, Inna Allah yuhibbu al-tawwabin wa yuhibbu al-mutatahirin.